Counseling at All Saints, under the auspices of the Lay Counseling Ministry, is an effort on the part of a cadre or a group of trained lay counselors such as myself, who work under the supervision of licensed mental health professionals to help folks, parishioners at All Saints, writ large really, it's quite inclusive, who are going through a tough patch in their lives.
Well, I was in yoga class and I happened to see a friend there who was also an All Saints person, and I asked if we could have lunch, and we had lunch, and I was in such anxiety at the lunch. I said, I have to tell you what's going on. I'm just really falling apart. And it turned out that she was a counselor in the lay counseling program, and she asked me to call the director, and I said, I will do it. I think I even did it when I got home from the lunch. I was desperate for anything that would help.
Counseling is a venue, an avenue, a conduit for people to connect, where the rubber meets the road, in the place of challenge or difficulty that all of us sometime go through. That counseling at All Saints is a place where you can be received and embraced.
I was surprised by the thoroughness of the intake interview. I was asked my thoughts about would I prefer a male or a female counselor, and what age, and when would I be available. I mean, it was so much left up to me. I was so pleased at that.
The best suited counselor is sort of determined from that interview, and also from the request of the person. Maybe you want someone that's male or female, or someone that's gay or lesbian. Whatever the preference is, we'll try to match that.
It is designed to provide short-term emotional support through the particular crisis or difficult patch the person's going through.
Well, I was going through a divorce and the issues involved with that, and I was being counseled by a pastoral care minister here, and she suggested that I might benefit from taking part in this program.
We provide a very powerful, sacred space for these people.
I'd had a cardiac arrest 2 years ago, and I was still trying to come to terms with that. I'm lucky to be alive. I'm extremely lucky to be alive.
All Saints gives you an opportunity to have that discussion that you really need to have with somebody who provides the kind of security that you're in a safe place.
I've come to find that sharing my story helps me to understand my story.
Family dynamic in our family changed, and I felt myself pulled in one direction and in the other direction to take sides. This was between children who were leaving each other, and I felt that I needed to remain neutral, but I didn't know if that was right or not, so I wanted to get some affirmation for that.
All of us as counselors are on the same page within the context of All Saints Church. We all begin with a multiple month training program where we meet each week and review what the counseling process is and how we go about that, and with a particular emphasis on listening.
And read the information about confidentiality. I was informed that who the lay pastoral counselors were and how they would report to a supervisor every two sessions.
It was very comfortable and relaxed, and I had no fear of sharing anything that I needed to share with my counselor.
It's totally confidential, and that is a core, indispensable principle of the ministry.
Now, therapy can often be long-term, and we're limited to
10 free, wonderful sessions.
After the approximately 10 sessions I had with a counselor, there is an opportunity to become part of an ongoing support group of people who have gone through the lay counseling ministry. And just knowing that that option was available to me, a group that met twice a month in the evenings, was just knowing that I was not going to be like stranded, emotionally stranded, but that group was there, just knowing that it was there was helpful. And I did go several times until I began to move on in my life and feel comfortable.
So this is a place where we can tell our stories without criticism, without judgment.
I felt that my counselor was an impeccable listener. I also found that my counselor and I shared a few similar things in our lives.
Really, it gave me my life back. It really did. It gave me a feeling that I could survive. I could find a way to deal with whatever came my way.
It's confidential, so that you have no worries about your business going around the church.
And just the words coming out of your mouth, a lot of times when you have issues and problems, those thoughts are going around and around in your head. When you start to verbalize them to somebody who's sympathetic and caring and intent on listening to you, somehow just the mere words coming out of your mouth resonate to the point where you can see which direction is right and which one is filled with problems.
And it's offered to anyone who feels the need to be valued, to be helped, to be loved.
Well, the surprise is that it was free. You know, the free 10 counseling sessions, that was great. And I loved the counselor. I got on well with her. I could open up to her. And that was fabulous.
This really gave me a heads up to give me the strength to move forward in my life.
I feel very happy that I've had counseling, and I have told a lot of people about it. And I feel much more confident myself in dealing with this particular family issue. And I think I feel a bit more confident. I have a greater sense of self-confidence because I've been affirmed, lovingly affirmed, in these counseling sessions. I was impressed with the fact that there was a candle lighted here that was lighted before every session. Prayers were said and offered, and blessings were offered. That really took me by surprise and made me feel very relaxed, as though I was in a nurturing, loving environment.
I believe that opening with a prayer with someone who is on a spiritual journey, and I'm on a spiritual journey, I think it links us together in that beautiful space. So that's really what helped me more than in a situation where it's secular counseling.
She said to me, "Well, I think we've really dealt with all the material. That was about session 6, so we could stop now." And I said, "Oh, I really want to continue," because I wanted to continue talking with her and receiving her wisdom and her thoughts in, as she reflected on what I had to say.
Those little small but very important things that were going on in my life to help me just live in the moment and do what I needed to do, and I was extremely grateful.
Yeah. Very positive. And yeah, she was extremely flexible, mm-hmm, with my weird schedule of being a retired person working part-time.
I had a good experience when I first came to All Saints, where I went up for prayer. We offer laying on of hands every Sunday at church services, and I went up and I was in a very troubled place, and I asked for prayer, and really what the woman told me was that I stand with you. And even though she didn't have a solution to my problem, her telling me that I stand with you, I felt a legion of angels come and stand with me at that moment. So that's what I hope to do for those that come to me, that I'll just let you know that whatever you're going through, I stand with you. Mm-hmm. And I think that that can speak volumes.
Coming here, you feel so welcomed. It's just, that's what All Saints is about.
I really enjoy listening. I think that's a key, is that you have to be willing to listen. And I kind of love listening. I love listening to people's stories.
Some of us haven't been listened to. Maybe all of us haven't been listened to really, really deeply. So this is a wonderful opportunity for people in this community to take advantage of. And they don't have to feel that something is wrong with them to take advantage of. They don't have to feel that they have a big problem. They may just want to talk what is deeply on their heart and deeply on their soul.
Aquí en la parroquia de Todos los Santos tenemos consejeros que tuvieron un entrenamiento por muchos meses, que se ofrece este servicio para cualquier persona que en su vida, en su peregrino de estar aquí en Todos los Santos, se necesita ayuda. Aquí la tenemos para cualquier persona que quiera. Y tenemos 10 sesiones gratis. No tienen que pagar, nomás tienen que estar aquí, hacer una cita con una persona asignada para una entrevista. Y luego esa entrevista, se requiere que ustedes lleguen aquí a tiempo y también firman unos papeles para comenzar la sesión. Cuando termina esta entrevista, lo que pasa es que un consejero le va a llamar a usted para seguir una cita, y el día y la hora más apropiada para usted para comenzar esas 10 sesiones.
I would highly recommend this, the lay counseling ministry, to anyone who's dealing with an uncertain moment in their life.
Give it a shot, give it a try. I know for myself, I'm a very private person and I'm sort of guarded. I don't really want people knowing all of my business unless I decide to tell you. And so I would just say to take advantage of this opportunity.
I'd highly recommend the lay counseling. You know, if you're going through, if anyone watches this, going through any kind of health issues or any kind of issues at work or personal life, to seek it out, because it can help you, and the great counselors.
If anyone is even slightly considering this as an option for their life, I would strongly encourage that person to pursue getting on the path. It can be such a transformational experience.